I'm not a morning person.
Dedicated to being passionate about it.
Bodybuilders have become more lazy.
People have always thought I lift fake weights.
Iran and the United States.
You take responsibility for that.
Do you think it's possible to be a competitive bodybuilder, whether pro or amateur level, where you compete, you know, you go through what bodybuilders go through, and still be healthy? Or do you feel like bodybuilding is an extreme sport where you kind of have to sacrifice some of your health to be a competitive bodybuilder?
I think on either end of the spectrum, natural or enhanced, there's risks that are involved. You know, for example, my path to being an enhanced athlete started with me on being on HRT at the age of 22, because I had just competed 4 years naturally and my test production was at 135. And that was after 8 months of testing. That was after getting an MRI on my pituitary. So being natural isn't any quote unquote healthier. I think the risk to organs obviously is vastly different. But just your overall well-being and health and sexual health, there's risks on either end of the coin. And again, it goes back to what I said, like if you want to be the best in any realm, there's risk involved. And just as much for a natural, there's a natural athlete that I'm working with right now who on paper didn't look like anything was wrong. And then he was in the same situation. You know, his LH and FSH are fine, but his free test and total test was very, very low. And that's just because he's pushed his body so hard in a natural state. And in a natural state, there's even more of an argument for rest and recovery. And if we don't give our bodies that, it's just going to downregulate hormonally.
Mm-hmm. Do you think high blood pressure is an issue in bodybuilders? Do you notice that trend or not?
I think high blood pressure is one of the biggest concerns within bodybuilding. Because again, it's very easy to not be aware of. It's very easy to just shut your mind off to. And it can wreak havoc on your body. It can wreak havoc on your kidneys. It can wreak havoc on your heart. And that's one of the main issues within bodybuilding. I would say that not being aware of your glucose levels, your A1C levels, and the synergy that those have as well with kidney health and function. Those are two of the biggest issues within bodybuilding.
What do you think is the right way to like keep the blood pressure low? Even if you work out completely unenhanced, it's still gonna bring it up a little bit. You know what I mean? Like what's the
during a bout of exercise, that's not really the concern. It's more so the chronic state of being elevated when from waking through at night. Like when you're exerting yourself, that's a natural response of how it should be that your blood pressure should increase. But it's just chronically staying high and chronically staying elevated. That's the issue. Now there's genetic, people genetically can have high blood pressure. Obviously there's people that have never touched a weight in their life, you know, due to whatever situation that they're in, they have high blood pressure. So it's not always bodybuilding related, but a lot of the variables within bodybuilding can attribute to high blood pressure. So you just need to be aware of it. I think one of the things too is we're in this cheat meal generation where it's, you know, it's about sticking to a diet and then having these massive cheat meals, and that can wreak havoc not only on your blood pressure, but also again on your glucose levels, on your A1C. So again, they all work together. But really, and I don't want to be taken the wrong way for saying this, because I've been saying the whole time that bodybuilding ultimately is not healthy, but trying to be as healthy as you can within the sport is the best way for longevity in terms of, you know, not eating junk food just to eat it, you know, choosing more nutrient dense food options, making sure that your water intake is high on a daily basis. Like simple things like that can go such a long way.